Given the function y, we want to find dy dx, or the derivative function. But looking at our function y, notice how we definitely have a product of two functions here, but also the first and second functions are also composite functions. So we'll have to apply the product rule with the chain rule. Whenever we're working with the chain rule, though, we normally want to begin by identifying the inner function. So looking at this first function, notice how the inner function would be 3x to the fifth plus 1, which we'll call u. Looking at the second function, notice how the inner function would be 2x to the seventh minus 5. We'll call this v. Let's keep track of all this on the side. We have u equals 3x to the fifth plus 1. Because we'll be applying the chain rule, we also want to find du dx or u prime. U prime would be equal to, 15x to the fourth. The derivative of 1 would be 0. And then v would be equal to 2x to the seventh minus 5. So v prime, or dv dx, would be equal to, 14x to the sixth. And again, the derivative of a constant is 0. Now we can think of the original function as y equals u to the fourth times v to the ninth. And now we'll apply the product rule to find dy dx. We're looking at our product rule. The first function f would actually be u to the fourth, and the second function g would be v to the ninth, which means dy dx would be equal to the first function, u to the fourth, times the derivative of v to the ninth with respect to x. That would be the derivative with respect to x of v to the ninth, which will require the chain rule, plus the second function, v to the ninth, times the derivative of the first function with respect to x, the derivative of u to the fourth with respect to x, which again will require the chain rule. Now let's find this derivative and this derivative. So we have dy dx equals u to the fourth times the derivative of v to the ninth with respect to x would be 9v to the eighth times v prime. Remember, we have to apply the chain rule here because we're differentiating with respect to x, not just v. And then we have plus v to the ninth times the derivative of u to the fourth with respect to x, that would be 4u to the third times u prime. And now we have our derivative function, it's just not in terms of x. So now we'll make substitutions for u, u prime, v, and v prime. So dy dx is going to be equal to u to the fourth, that would be 3x to the fifth plus 1 to the fourth, times 9 times v to the eighth, which should be 2x to the seventh minus 5 to the eighth, times v prime, which is 14x to the sixth. And we have plus v to the ninth, which should be 2x to the seventh minus 5 to the ninth, times 4 times u to the third, that's 3x to the fifth plus 1 to the third, times u prime, which would be 15x to the fourth. Let's begin to simplify this. 9 times 14x to the sixth would be 126x to the sixth. And then we have 4 factors of 3x to the fifth plus 1. And we have 8 factors of 2x to the 7th minus 5. Plus, looking at the second product here, we have 4 times 15x to the 4th, that'd be 60x to the 4th. And then we have 9 factors of 2x to the 7th minus 5, and 3 factors of 3x to the 5th plus 1. So in many cases, you can probably leave your derivative function in this form here. But I'm also going to show how we can factor this further and simplify further. So let's take this on the next slide and continue. Looking at this product and this product, let's begin by looking at 126x to the sixth and 60x to the fourth. The greatest common factor of these two terms would be 6x to the fourth. So for the next step, we're going to factor out 6x to the fourth. But also, if we look at the factors of 3x to the fifth plus 1, we have 4 of them here and 3 of them there. Let's go ahead and factor out 3 of them. If we take a look at the factors of 2x to the 7th minus 5, we have 8 of them here and 9 of them here. So we'll go ahead and factor out 8 of them. So let's see what's left. If we factor out 6x to the 4th from 126x to the 6th, that leaves us with 21x to the 2nd. We're factoring out 3 factors of 3x to the 5th plus 1, but we had 4 of them. That leaves us with 1 factor of 3x to the 5th plus 1. And we're factoring out all of the factors of 2x to the 7th minus 5. And now for the second product, if we factor out 6x to the 4th, that would leave us with 10. We're factoring out 8 factors of 2x to the 7th minus 5. We had 9 of them though, so there's 1 factor left. And notice how we factor out all 3 factors of 3x to the 5th plus 1. So now we'll simplify inside these brackets by distributing and combining like terms. So we'd have 63x to the 7th plus 21x squared, and then plus 20x to the 7th minus 50. And for the last step, we do have 2 like terms here. There are 2x to the 7th terms. So if you are asked to factor the derivative function completely, it would look like this. We'd have 6x to the 4th times 3x to the 5th plus 1 to the 3rd times 2x to the 7th minus 5 to the 8th. And then we'd have 83x to the 7th plus 21x squared minus 50. Personally, I don't think all this algebra is necessary, but just in case you are required to show it, here's the factored form of the derivative function. But if we're not required to simplify it as much as this, we could just leave it in this form here. I hope you found this helpful.